Recording in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Greetings, fellow Wiccans. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with our quick missions. Today's mission at hand is Mission Frontrunner, which takes place in East Africa. 0630 hours. The weather is clear. And it is a sunny day for shedding some terrorist blood. The summary says, rebel forces recently hijacked a convoy of relief supplies intended for the local civilian population. Free the drivers and escort them and the supply trucks to safety. And that's all it is. So, yeah, I'm guessing it's a convoy ambush mission. And these missions don't always seem as easy as they're supposed to be. So, let's see. We'll get to figure out more once we read the mission briefing. Yep.
A convoy of relief supplies has been hijacked by neighboring rebels. They are trying to starve out the local population in preparation for a land grab. The drivers and their vehicles are being held inside the rebel base. You are ordered to infiltrate the camp and free the captured drivers. Bravo will insert southwest of the main camp and is responsible for locating and freeing the hostages. Alpha Team will secure the egress route and Charlie will provide overwatch. Once the drivers are free, all teams will escort the trucks along the northeast road to the rally point. These rebels are not interested in keeping the supplies, so they may try to destroy the convoy rather than let it escape.
Okay, that's a heavy mission. And, we are getting recommended a law, so I'm guessing that there will be a helicopter. I was thinking that instead of this gun, I might go for the saw. But I feel like we might need the range in this mission. I guess we will just head out with this loadout itself.
King 6 to all elements. The truck should be inside the base. Eliminate all hostiles and escort the trucks out of there. Charlie Team, provide security. Alpha Team, secure the egress.
Roger, King 6.
Roger that!
And I got hit on the way down by a random sniper. And it has been lagging the game all the while. So the last time around I accidentally killed the hostages, and despite us being briefed that the hostages are actually civilians, they are wearing camo. It's not technically not my fault that I accidentally killed the hostages. Although, I suppose I'm the only one who can be held accountable for such an error, but yeah. That's how things be. That is how things be. Wait, there are enemies on this side? I thought I killed them all. Huh. Dead enemies, I guess. The best kinds of enemies, to be honest. Now, I would like to be a little cautious, but I already know the layout of this level. Not down to a T, I would say, but I think I know the layout of this level quite well at this point. To be disregard caution just a bit. Like, no need to be so cautious. There's one guy there will be another on the right, and there are like a few guys in here. That's one guy down. Fungi down. And the reason I came up here is so that I could destroy this, Really? BRDM over here? Oh, right. Let me just hide that. So yeah, the enemies don't really execute any hostages. We do. Accidentally. That's what I did last time around. Because they were wearing khaki and I thought, well, must be an enemy then. Turns out that was a rather grave miscalculation on my part. Wait, enemy? Looks like I don't need to use a grenade round this time around. Now, the hostages are on the first floor. Getting to them is quite straightforward. I didn't realize there would be three enemies in there. Well, I guess that was just my oversight. Now, there are two more enemies in there, and should be another one in there, to be honest. Let me just take care of a grenade launcher. Is that the enemy? Yes, yes it is. There are like some guys who tend to patrol the area and they can typically cause havoc for you. Now the good thing is, once the enemies are taken care of, on the outside at least, Alpha and Charlie will come in and form a perimeter, so if there is any sort of firing... You can... be assured that it's actually the enemies nearby. That's all the enemies there, and we already cleared this room out. Could be some enemies coming from there, but yeah, Alpha is there to cover that side. Now there are folks in here that we also need to get rid of. One right here. I guess you, my dear sir, are getting inside and getting into an eternal rest. Why is this not breaking? I guess I was phasing through it. The wall, I mean. Now, the reason that I'm going behind this place is simple. There are enemies inside that we can take out from here. One on that side, one over here, and maybe one over there. Because I think that's where all the enemies are anyway. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I don't accidentally want to hit any hostages in there, so... Anyway, switching back to burst mode, and we have taken out as many as we could from the outside. No time to infiltrate this place and take out the rest. Could be an enemy around the corner here. Thankfully there was none. Definitely should be an enemy right there. Now here's the thing. I checked in so many grenades, but these guys are still alive. Which sort of baffles me. That should not be the case, really. Now when we get upstairs, the hostages will be on the left. They will be wearing the same camouflage that these guys are wearing, which makes it sort of difficult to tell who's the enemy and who's not. The place behind us is clear. No! So those guys are the hostages. And yeah, I don't think there is any enemy here. In this room, I mean. I'm just going to check these halls nonetheless, in case there is one. There is none. I don't think I saw an enemy upstairs, and even if there was, they probably would have shown themselves by now, so I guess it's time we escort the hostages to... well, the trucks. Now, we have already taken care of one of the BRDMs. I don't know if there are more, but the one that I saw already took care of it. Oh, wait, I completely forgot to neutralize any enemies in there. Alpha 1 is at least standing there. I see only one BRDM, to be honest. Now, you guys wait for me, alright? You guys don't go gung-ho and just...
This is King 6. Get those trucks out of there!
Bravo, this is Charlie 1. You've got some bad guys moving in on the trucks.
Come on. Do we need to walk alongside of them? Okay, Charlie is also following us. Thankfully, none of our friends have died yet. I just hope that we don't die either while we're doing this. Semi-auto. Setting to semi-auto. So basically, none of the trucks should be destroyed. was the condition. And yeah, we need to play this mission accordingly. Make sure that none of the trucks get destroyed. None of the civilians should be harmed and none of the trucks should be destroyed. It's a pretty standard peacekeeping mission, if you ask me. I should probably be running ahead in front of the truck. I was thinking I'll just hitch a ride in the truck itself, but I guess that's not entirely possible. With Alpha leading the way, I think clearing the route would be easier. As it was, I think there were only four enemies that we had to encounter.
All King elements, convoy is secure. Good work, everyone.
No enemies in sight. King 6. Delta forces are to be over and out. So Delta Force is apparently an abbreviation. It's supposed to be like a branch of special operatives. Now, when they say special operatives, I don't know what they mean, but it is supposed to be essentially a branch of, you know, I think it's a branch of para commandos, if I'm not wrong, or well, special forces is what it says. Something special forces detachment Delta is why it is called the Delta Force. It's like it's supposed to be like just this one regiment in the United States military, if I'm not wrong, which is infamous for peacekeeping operations. So the same thing with Army Rangers, actually. So it's curious how some of these particular regiments gain popularity despite following the same, you know, training regimen as the rest. Maybe the training regimen differs, but anyhow, we are sort of digressing here. That was it for Mission Frontrunner, and it was an interesting mission. Pretty straightforward, to be honest. I honestly just killed one of the civilians the first time around, and well, it's not exactly my fault they were wearing camouflage, alright? So, I mean, even though they had their hands up, I suppose that's your trigger discipline, and Geneva Conventions come into effect, even though Geneva Conventions don't really apply to illegal combatants like terrorists. So, anyhow, this was it for Mission Frontrunner. When we come back, we will be covering Mission Payback, which is a level that I've really tried a lot. Like, I played through this level a lot during the initial stages when I was trying to configure this game for, you know, YouTube. So, yeah, when we come back, we will be covering Mission Payback. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow friends.